Shabbat Shalom, Chag Sameach. You know, several weeks ago, Gordon Lightfoot died. And I gave my sermon, and I even sang a Gordon Lightfoot song. And I received incredible feedback and even praise on that singing and on that sermon from our members, from non-members, from throughout our area, from all across the country, even from Israel, did I receive such celebration of that sermon on Gordon Lightfoot. You know, Tina Turner died this week. I got nothing for you. We are now at the Yizkor Hour. It is said that Yizkor is not only a time to remember, but it's an opportunity to move forward. Because in knowing that we have four times throughout the year the opportunity to come together and remember those four Yizkors, Yom Kippur, Sukkot, Pesach, and Shavuot, as well as the Yortzeiten, that our loved ones will never be forgotten, that we know we have built into the year opportunity to pause and to remember, and then we can move forward again. Because part of what we do at Yizkor is to celebrate the best qualities of those whom we remember, and we pledge at least to ourselves, if not to God as well, that we will live in such a way to make our loved ones whom we remember proud, that we'll live in such a way to make them proud. And all the more so, too, there are some who we remember who were broken. If we're honest, all of us are at least a little bit broken. And so we vow to live lives in such a way that how we live can bring tikkun, can bring repair to that which caused our loved ones fear or anxiety, sadness or compulsion. No, I won't be singing to you from Tina Turner this week. But I want to share with you a short story that I read in this new book from Rabbi Daniel Gordas, who was our Baker Scholar in Residence last month. The book is called Impossible Takes Longer. And of course, it's about Israel. Rabbi Gordas writes that the Sheba Medical Center is now recognized by many as Israel's finest hospital. At first, Sheba toiled to climb its way up the Israeli ladder and then spread its focus outward, establishing Sheba International. Its focus expanded to include medical tourism, clinical collaboration, collaboration with startups, fellowships around the world, and field hospitals in areas struck by disaster and more. The goal was to maximize Sheba's global impact. When Sheba made the list of the world's top 10 hospitals in 2019, its director, Professor Yitzhak Kreis, got a phone call from his mother, who had worked at Sheba as a nursing assistant for 40 years. When the professor answered the phone, though, his mother was so overcome with pride, she was so overcome with emotion, that she was unable to speak. His father, a Holocaust survivor, took the phone from his wife, from Professor Yitzchak's mother, and his father got right to the point. Yitzchak, he said, the horrors of his own past coloring even that moment of pride in his son. Next year, I want you to pass the Germans. You hear me? We are, on this day of memory, giving honor to those who came before us. We're honoring the loved ones who are no longer here and able to sit next to us. Husbands and wives, mothers and fathers, sisters and brothers, friends, and even tragically, children. And as we remember today, we vow to live in such a way that will make them proud of us. We pledge to live in such a way that will make God proud of us. And we pledge, too, that we should live in such a way to bring tikkun, to bring repair, to heal that which was broken before. In this way, we can remember. And in this way, we can go on with our lives to better living, to more meaningful living, to more Jewish living. At this Yizkor hour now, in this time of memory, we take the opportunity to dedicate a new generation of memorial plaques. And so we pray, our God and God of all generations, author of all life, our lives are in your hand. We are but sojourners upon this earth. We recognize that the same fate awaits us all, whether we are simple or wise, rich or poor, great or small. Death levels all distinctions. We are all equal in death. The memories of those who are gone from us should stir us to better living, to kind words, to just and noble deeds, and to lofty ideals, so that when the time comes for others to remember us, we may have left the world better than we found it. Thus shall life become a song to immortality. Thus shall life be master over death. Teach us, dear God, to make our everyday count, that we may obtain a heart of wisdom and lead a life of blessing. As we name those for whom the memorial plaque will bear their names, we'll invite their family members to rise. So today we remember and we honor the names of Robert Brody, Rena Chernow, Iris Fink, Todd Fink, Hilda Green, Emmerich Grossinger, Lawrence Harry Jonas, Sally Rita Cornwise Katz, Eleanor Korn, Stephen J. Koss, Kimberly Levin, Sisterhood Past President, Gerald Michael Levine, Toby Foreman Sackett, Saul Shepsel Salson, Leo Sklar, Manuel Manny Sklar, Sidney Seufer, Jerome Leon Stein, Estelle Hadassah Lavostein, Dorothy Fisher Tesler, and A. Robert Zeff. We dedicate these memorial plaques to all whose names they bear, as individuals, as families, as in a synagogue community. We will look upon these names and remember that life is a precious gift, and that there is much meaning in life for those who will to see it. It is not death, but rather life, that will claim our thoughts. In the presence, then, of the family, friends, and community of those whose names we remember today, whom we memorialize now in our sacred home, we consecrate those memorial plaques before you, God, source of all life, in the abiding faith that though death is inevitable, the memories of our loved ones will endure. May they be remembered for a blessing. And let us say together, Amen. You may be seated. I'll invite you now to take out your Yizkor booklets. We begin our Yizkor service now on page 3.
Adonai Roi Lorsal Dino Deshe Yarbitzeini Almei Menuchot Almei Menuchot Yena Aleini Nafshi Shulchan.
Turn now to the back of our Yizkor booklets. We're on page 79. Page 79, we'll join together responsibly in the words of Rabbi Morris Adler. The earth has covered only that which was mortal, of those to whom we have said our farewell. We shall not see again the familiar glowing face, the warm illuminated eye, nor hear the beloved voice. We shall not sit face to face across the family table or side by side in the home of a friend or in worship. We shall not feel the kiss that once evoked our deepest response. Yet death has failed and must surrender, for the beloved who is gone lives and will always live through the years, not in some distant corner of our being to be uncovered only in a rare moment or by a sudden surge of recall. The beloved has become a presence, indwelling and inseparable, rooted so deep that life cannot carry us far from the cherished, now hallowed center of memory and love. Your hand, O death, has been stayed. You can no longer inflict oblivion or doom to full disappearance those who were life of our life. They live and move within us in spheres beyond your dominion. We thank thee, O God of life and love, for the resurrecting gift of memory, which endows thy children fashioned in thy image with a godlike sovereign power to give immortality through love. Blessed be thou, O God, who enablest thy children to remember. And we say, Amen. We continue now on page 5. You'll turn with me again to the back of your Yizkor booklets. We're on page 80. Page 80, whenever I would offer this reading on a Yom Tov from our beloved Rabbi Erwin Groner, of blessed memory, immediately after the holiday, I would receive a text message from Lipsa. Thank you, Rabbi, she wrote. Thank you. As we read Rabbi Groner's words, we think of both our Rebbetzin and our Rabbi. May they both be remembered for a blessing. We come before you, dear God, Rabbi Groner wrote. Dear God, we come before you as individuals created in your image and as a congregation in Israel to thank you for your blessings. We are grateful for inspiring moments. We ask not to be relieved of our burdens, but to be fortified to bear them. We ask not for a spontaneous solution to our problems, but rather for the guidance to meet them with firmness and understanding. We ask not for an escape from the difficult choices we make, but rather for insight and courage to choose wisely and bravely. It seems to some of us that we have lost you. Dare we commend ourselves to you, we who have given so much? We can lay no compelling claim to added blessing, yet we must. You know how frail we are, how uncertain is our life. Our very existence is in your hands. Another year and we grow older along with it. Life becomes more precious as we sense time's rapid passing. If only we could grow in wisdom as we grow in years. Your prophet declared, "Seek the Lord where he can be found." Where shall we find you? And where shall we not find you? Some of us have known gladness and fulfillment. Others have known sorrow and disappointment. Some of our lives have been touched by moments of high ecstasy, and some have been seared by unspeakable tragedy. You were ever with us. You sustained us. You uplifted us. If only we could have opened our eyes. Link our names with prophets and sages and saints who labor to preserve your teaching. Enable us to continue their sacred work. Unroll our days as a scroll and use our lives as holy parchment in which to inscribe eternal truths. Help us make our page meaningful and our script sincere, an acceptable offering to you. Enable us to encounter you in the sacred legacy of our tradition. Enable us to love you with all our heart, with all our soul, with all our might. Come closer to us and remain in our midst. We do not want to fail you. But God, do not fail us. You are our loving Father. We are humbly and devoutly your children. And let us say, Amen. We'll invite the congregation to rise now, please, as the Arona Kodesh is open by Eric Grossinger and by Carrie Alterman in memory of Emery Grossinger. The Sefer Torah will be removed, and we will continue silently now, pages 7 through 12, with the individual Yizkor meditations. Yizkor Elohim Nishmot Krovai Verei. May God remember the souls of all those who perished in the Shoah. May God remember the souls of our brothers and sisters who died in defense of the State of Israel. May God remember the souls of all who died in defense of these United States of America. May God remember the souls of all of our relatives and friends who have gone to their eternal home. In loving testimony to their lives, may we endeavor to perpetuate ideals important to them. Through such deeds, and through tzedakah, righteous giving, along with prayer and memory, are their souls bound up in the bond of life. May these moments of meditation strengthen the ties that link me to their memory. May they rest forever in dignity and peace, with fullness of joy, in the comfort of your eternal presence. And let us say together, Amen. Amen. We continue on page 15.
El Malei Rachamim Shochein Bamaromim Hamtzei Menucha Nechona Tachat Kanfei HaShechina B'malot Kedoshim Kedoshim Otehorim כזוהר הרקיע, מזהירים לנשמות, כל אלה שהזכרנו היום לברכה, שהלכו Lamam began Eden, began Eden, Tehei Meluchatam. Ana Balarachamim, Askirem Beseiter, Kenofecha Leyolamim. Utzeror bitzeror achayim, utzeror bitzeror achayim, het nishmotayhem, Adonai hu nachalatam, v'yanuchu b'shalom, v'yanuchu Shalom al mishkevotam b'shalom v'nomar amen.
Exalt and compassionate God, grant infinite rest in your sheltering presence among the holy and the pure, to the souls of our loved ones who have gone to their eternal home. Merciful One, we ask that they find perfect peace in your tender embrace. May their memories endure, inspiring truth and loyalty in our lives. May their souls be bound up in the bond of life. May they forever rest in peace. And let us say together, Amen. Amen. We'll continue together on page 16 with the Mourner's Kaddish. Yitgadal v'yitkadash shemei rabbah, v'alma divra kirutei v'yamlich machutei, בחייכון וביומיכון, בחיי דכל בית ישראל, בעגלה ובזמן קריב, אמרו אמן. יהי שמי רבה מבורך לעולם ומי ומי. יתברך וישתבח, ויתפאר ויתרומם ויתנשא. ויתהדר ויתעלה ויתהלל שמי דקודשה וריחו. לעילה מלכו ברכתה ושירתה. Tushbechata v'nechamata, namiran v'yoma v'imru amen. Yehe shlama rabba min shemaya, v'chayim aleinu v'yalko Yisrael v'imru amen. Ose shalom v'imroma, hu ya'ase shalom, aleinu v'yalko Yisrael,
v'imru.
Amen. May all those whom remember today be remembered for a blessing, and may they rest now and always in peace as we remember them. I'll invite you to turn with me to page 18 in your Yizkor booklets. You may be seated. We resume in our blue prayer book.